Welcome back to Investor Intel. I'm Peter Clausi with a new and extremely interesting story today. We're going to be talking with Ankgor Gold about how to de-risk a project by engaging the community. Stephen Burega, thank you for coming in today.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Now, Ankgor Gold was new to me. You have five packages, almost 1,000 square kilometers land, but it's in Cambodia. So to a North American investor, the biggest question is, well, where's Cambodia? And then following that one, how do you de-risk a project in Cambodia?
Well, Cambodia is located right between Vietnam and Thailand, and you have Laos along the top. Our properties are in the northeast quadrant in a region called Ratanakiri and Mondulkiri. As a country, it's developed extremely well. Over the past 10 years, a lot of foreign direct investments come to the table.
Angkor Wat is in Cambodia, isn't it?
Sure it is.
The world famous UNESCO heritage site.
That's right. Okay. That's right. That's where most people are familiar with Cambodia. Now, what they're not familiar with is that the plumbing's amazing. They've got spectacular geology. And it was forgotten for 40 plus years.
Why was that? Was that fallout from the Vietnam War and that whole area being marginalized?
Not necessarily. Well, Vietnam War, of course, had a major impact, but it was more Pol Pot, the Khmer Rouge. I mean, there's some serious post-war issues that they've struggled with, but Cambodia now is a vibrant, young country, growing at an exceptional rate.
English speaking,
growing at an average 7% GDP annually. And it's one of the youngest countries in the world as far as the average age is concerned. So they're hungry to grow, hungry to succeed. And we're fortunate to have been there now for 9 years.
Wow.
We IPO'd in 2011, but before that we were there as of 2009. And
So how do you de-risk a project by engaging the community?
It's not only engaging the community, it's engaging all levels of government, all the way up from the Prime Minister's office down to the local community. So from the outset, we realized that our relationships with community leadership all the way down through youth groups, et cetera, was going to be vital to the success of any project moving forward.
Right.
So Mike Weeks and Delayne Weeks, who are the founders of the company, put a lot of effort into establishing those relationships. And we focus on corporate development, our corporate social responsibility programs at all levels. You want some specific ideas?
Yeah, please.
Some of the work that we do with the local communities include education programs, healthcare programs, water sanitation issues, latrines. Some of the basic things that we would take for granted are simply not available to the average community. So we work closely with them, but it's not simply a handout. The idea really has always been that it's a co-funding model. We'll provide all of the materials, for example, to build a latrine, but each individual household who's receiving one, they have to put the labor and the time and the effort so that they own it.
Like a Habitat for Humanity model.
There's some similarities there for sure. But that also now allows us to then take it to the next level, which is we're an exploration company. We're not a social development company.
So you must be hiring some of the local community members, training them, educating them.
We certainly are.
Passing that knowledge through the community.
I would say more than 90% of our staff, 95% of our staff in country are Khmer, are local Cambodians. We train the staff exceptionally well, and so much so that often they end up working with the government at the end of the day. They'll come back and work with us at some points, but really what we do is we focus on trying to give the core set skill sets needed so that we can run our exploration operation.
How's your relationship with the Ministry of Mining?
Exceptional. Absolutely exceptional. Often Ankgor Gold is put on a bit of a pedestal and looked at by the Prime Minister's office all the way down as the gold standard, no pun intended. Really what they've done is that they see that we've taken a new model we've never played the bribe game. We've never looked at trying to acquire assets without the permitting and the appropriate steps taken. So they look at
it's
us.
It's like the stereotypical Canadian way of doing business. We'll go in and be the good guys.
We'll be the good guys, sure, absolutely. And being one of the earliest players in country, as of 2009, we set the bar extremely high. We really looked to bring that Canadian standard right from the outset, and it's been appreciated and it's been respected and acknowledged all the way through.
So in the field, then, what's the next big operational milestone?
Well, we have two major partners. There's two sides to our business. We have our partnerships, one with Jogmec, for example.
Out of Japan.
Out of Japan. We are the operators on that project, and that's a $3 million three-year deal that is specifically focused on the Halo prospect, which is a copper porphyry that we're very excited about. We're into our second round of funding. A second $1 million has just been announced, and this next quarter will be focused on operating on that asset. We have another partnership with...
Before you do the other partnership, what are you doing at that asset? Is that drilling, boots and hammers?
Drilling. We're at that drilling phase. So we did a lot of exploration work originally over the years, and we wanted to find the best possible partner. We've identified Jokkmokk. It took us 2 years to solidify the deal. We brought them to the table. We've drilled four holes to date, four 400-meter holes. The very first hole we drilled was mineralized from surface down to 100 meters at 0.3 copper. Not bad for our first hole.
First go round.
Now our second round is going to be another additional three or four holes, 1,200 meter small project. We're going to be shooting some more IP, and we're going to step out from where we had success, and we're going to see where else what we've got there.
You were talking then about a second partnership.
Our second partnership is with a group called Emerald Resources. Emerald is an Australian publicly listed company. They acquired Renaissance. Renaissance is another Australian listed company that has what's called the Okvau mining license, our mining tenement. They have a 1.2 million ounce deposit.
Also in Cambodia.
Also in Cambodia, about 80 kilometers south of the license that we partnered with them on. That's called the Cognac license. And that's a $2+ million two-year deal where we're going to, where we're not the operator. They're doing all the work. But at the end of the day, we end up with a 20% free carry through to production.
Nice.
It's a nice model.
So the next big operational milestone then would be at which one of those two projects?
The big one's going to be results out of the Halo prospect, which is that copper porphyry where we're partners with Jokkmokk. And then we're going to be moving forward on working on our Banlung license. It's a 100% owned license where we have two key targets, Okala East and Okala West. Okala East looks to be the same model as we see at Halo as far as a copper porphyry, copper gold porphyry, and then Okala West is an epithermal gold system.
Great. Thanks for coming in today, and thank you for your time. Please leave comments below. An interesting story of de-risking with community social responsibility.
Thanks very much for having me.
Thanks for your time.